sure to add the town librarian to our list.
They just throw you back in the middle of the line. That's crazy.
Report to Clive to stay alive. Next caller is up, Forrest, so take it away.
All right, they throw you right in. They don't give you no time
to Forrest Nash on 189.16.
The Scream.
Hey, wonderful show tonight, Forrest.
Thank you. Yeah, what the fuck you mean?
Wonderful, but
this whole show been crazy.
Thanks. What's your name, caller?
You can call me Dawn.
Hey, Dawn.
Can you play my tune, Forrest?
She sound kind of hot.
Sure.
Long ride home.
That old song.
What?
Sure. We got it.
Long ride.
Played it the other day.
Thanks. It'll be.
I gotta go find this on there.
All right, folks. Coming up is that old classic.
Forrest, don't think you're gonna find that song.
Why not?
What do you mean? I played it a few nights ago.
I know, but we don't have it anymore.
What are you talking about?
Do we need to call her?
You threw it in the trash.
I gotta go outside to get this.
I threw it out the window earlier today.
You stupid bitch. No, you gotta go get it.
And why did you throw it out the window earlier today?
Brad was annoying me all afternoon.
What they gotta do with the song?
He put it on repeat because he knows I don't like it. So I grabbed it and threw it right out of one of the office windows. Not my finest hour, but I can only take so much.
Yeah.
For shame, Peggy. For shame.
Definitely shame her ass. I'm not going to get it.
Let's just play a different song. We've got more important things to think about anyway.
Gotcha. Okay, folks. Here comes some unrequested music.
I'm just going to keep
this
song
playing.
Sorry
about that, Dawn. Maybe try again.
Nah, tomorrow. I'm going to switch it.
Sorry.
Put this back. Hold up. I want to play this one. Have I played every song? I know I played a couple of them on accident. We're going to play this one. I might have played this already. It doesn't matter. Let's introduce this one.
Enjoy this one as much as I do.
Only because, you know. That was a very lame introduction.
Of all the songs to request, why did it have to be that one?
Gee, Peggy, what did the barn finds ever do to you?
Wrote that song, for one. It gets real old when you're forced to listen to it on repeat for years.
Why couldn't they just request Roddy?
Roddy?
Forrest, we already heard. Song. We have another caller.
Because we already listened to Roddy.
Sorry to cut the music short, folks. Callers take priority tonight. Welcome to 189.16 The Scream. This is Forrest Nat.
Murphy?
Forrest. Oh, thank God. It's me again. Murphy.
I don't actually remember.
Talk to me, Murphy. What's wrong?
Oh, the killer got me, man. Why did I ever trust a guy named Master Robin?
What is he talking about?
That's not important right now. Just tell me what happened.
Goddamn Gleason. He came to the gallows waste disposal plant. Beat on me, man.
He said beat. I thought he said pee.
I got a flashlight, but oh goddamn! I smell smoke. I think he started a fire.
Hold on, Murphy. We'll call for help right now.
You gotta hurry, man. I need someone here now, or I'm gonna die.
Wait.
Peggy, get the fire department on the line.
On it.
Okay, never mind. What was I saying? There's no police dispatch.
Now just. Come on, pick up.
How's she know the fire department line off the top of her head like that?
Yes, I'd like to report a fire over at the gallows waste disposal plant. It's an emergency.
How come we didn't hear the police?
What do you mean it's not operational?
We have to police the...
Why is there no backup vehicle?
What?
God damn it! Forrest, that evil son of a bitch slashed the tires on the town's only fire engine. They can't do anything.
These niggas can't change the tires?
Live nearby.
How you don't got
them can save
how you don't got no backup tires, bro?
My friend Alex lives on the corner of Haddonfield and Romero Street, and Catherine lives on the west end of Myers Lane. And there's Jericho on the east end of Myers
Lane. He's over here, right?
But he's old.
Myers Lane.
Really old.
Okay, I'll check the map, see who would be best to do this.
Damn. I was not paying attention to where she said these niggas was at. Okay. Alex lives on the corner of... Alright, so we're trying to get somebody over here, right? Damn. Honestly, bro, I was listening, but I thought I heard something. So, I'm pretty sure we're trying to get somebody to the waste disposal, right? Because what else? I don't think there's any more plants here. Train station. Church. It's got to be over here. Okay, so. Alex lives on the corner of Haddonfield next to Romero. So where is that? Haddonfield and Romero. He lives right here. Catherine lives at the west end of Myers Lane, northeast, southwest is the left side. Right? Is there a compass on here? West is over here. Myers Lane? So she stayed down here. I think this dude is probably going to be the closest. The old man lives at the east end of Myers Lane, which is this side. So he stays about right here, somewhere over here. But he's slow, so we got to call Alex. How do I tell who to call?
All right, Forrest, who should I call?
You got to call
Murphy.
Alex.
Call Alex.
All right, give me a second.
That's if I'm actually trying to get somebody here. I think that's where we was trying to go. This nigga probably asleep. It's 2 a.m.
They're on the way. They'll call from the plant. You can direct them from there.
Well, let's hope they get there in time.
All right. This game loads pretty fast.
Call.
It's not lit up.
Are you sure you can't?
What's happening, Peggy?
Alex was too far away. Too slow.
What?
The plant burned down. It collapsed. So Murphy is... Poor Fernando is gonna be crushed.
Damn. Psych is dead.
Jeez.
Damn.
That's no way for anyone to die.
Guess I lost my first person.
Terrible way to go.
Yeah. Murphy.
He was trying to get here, right?
Stop this. For you and for Fernando.
Bro, what?
It's going to be our...
Forrest, we have another caller.
How the fuck did
he... Let's not waste time.
I'm upset now. I'm actually upset. It's not lighting up.
Another of our good citizens is on the line. Let's see what they have to say.
I'm upset. I was trying to save everybody.
The scream.
How the fuck, bro?
Forrest Nash.
Forrest. Teddy Gallows.
That doesn't make sense to me.
I just want to say that my thoughts and prayers are with my Gallows Creek neighbors during this awful time.
Oh, it's mayoral candidate and scion of the town founders, Mr. Gallows. Are you in danger?
We need to be a town of law and order. We need cops who have the tools and funding they need to keep us safe.
Okay, hang up,
Teddy.
Hang up.
I know you're an outsider.
He's trying to win votes right now. Hang up.
Here, Forrest. But you're really stepping up to bat for us all tonight. I just want to say thank you for taking a swing for Gallows Creek.
Jackass.
Yeah, hang up. Yeah, you're a prick,
I
want to
make sure I get this out on air to all of Gallows Creek. You're a real prick, Teddy.
I just want to make sure our town is safe and prosperous.
Why are so many people up at 2 o'clock in the morning?
Family factory founded by my father.
Well, I guess the news of a killer might get around to the 20 people that did hear the radio. They probably call people too.
Teddy, unless you've got an emergency, I'm cutting you off.
I guess he's
gone.
You know
what? I do have a problem. A problem that's ruining our town.
Hang up.
You know what it is?
Oh, your famous waste plant right now.
I didn't ask about a problem. I said emergency.
The problem.
He said the wasteland.
That woman, our current mayor.
So we were trying to get somebody right here, bro. Bro said he was right here, bro. How are you late? I'm really mad about that. How you couldn't get down the fucking road?
You're not better than anyone, Teddy. Just because you inherited half the town, it.
Your producer sounds a little unstable too.
Don't you dare speak to me that way.
Cut him off, Peggy.
I can guarantee this kind of thing will not happen when I take office. The moral decay of.
And took that's long enough of Teddy Gallows Jr. for one lifetime.
I always feel disgusting after hearing him talk.
I do like how they actually like
they'll be right back after these messages.
They actually changed how your shots go. Like some shots will actually be short, even if you hit like the same spot. That's actually pretty cool. I don't know if I play this one or not, but
the world famous annual Gallows Creek Harvest Festival.
I actually did play this one.
We got it all.
It doesn't matter.
Let me
see something real fast. I'll be right back.
Hello, caller. You're live on the stream with me, Forrest.
Wow. I literally just sat down and now somebody's at the door.
Dream with me, Forrest Nash.
My bad. Okay, somebody's gonna attack you again.
Hello, caller.
No. Who is this? I need the police.
I'm Forrest Nash. I'm standing in for 911 tonight. What's wrong?
There's a guy hunting me and my friends. I think he's killed some of them already.
All right.
That's him.
I'm still mad that we lost somebody, bro.
He's just a kid.
Where are you?
Where are you? Are you somewhere safe?
Oh my god, oh my god.
Stay with me, kid. Focus.
I can't do this.
She's hyperventilating.
Focus. Tell me, what's your name?
Sweetie, you can do it. What's your name?
Carrie.
Come on, Carrie.
Carrie, listen to me. We're gonna get you out of there. All right? Now, where are you?
The old murder house.
The old murder house? What the fuck are you doing there?
I'm at the end of a hall. There's a bathroom, like a entrance.
The old murder house?
Oh, he's coming. Where should I go?
I should have been paying more attention. Go to the closet.
Go to the closet.
Okay, I'll. He's here. He's gonna kill me.
Maybe if you shut up.
I don't think we can.
Don't move.
Don't move.
Did I just get her killed, bro? If she runs out, she's definitely gonna die.
Oh no! Oh no! Ah! Oh no!
My bad.
Forrest!
I should've seen your face!
What?
Wait,
what?
Was that a joke?
What?
Are you kidding me?
Okay, what the hell is going on here?
Okay.
Oh, who's on the phone, Carrie? The cops? It's just a joke, jeez.
Wait, isn't that...
Jimmy!
That's Jimmy?
Funny, you sicko! Of course I called the cops, but some guy just answered instead.
What guy?
Forrest Nash, what the hell are you all doing?
It's prank night, old man.
just having fun.
Are these like the frat kids?
The kid who called in earlier pretending to be the whistling man.
That's it. I'm out of here.
Go home, Jimmy.
You know he's really out there tonight, Jimmy, right?
Yeah, right. It's just whistling night, man.
That little idiot.
Whistling night?
It's a stupid tradition. Especially stupid since that one kid died back in... Would you take off that stupid mask if it's hard to breathe? Who's under there anyway? Is that you, Seth?
They got the real whistling man.
Seth is right next to you.
Yeah, it's the real whistling man in there with them stupid ass kids.
Wait.
Oh no.
Who are you?
Jump him. Well,
everyone, get inside.
Sounds like Jimmy got what he deserved. Run.
Not much.
I guess.
But we have to.
Heather.
Alright, let me focus this time.
The cops. Forrest picked up. He's the best we're gonna get.
Who is with
My friend. It's so sad.
We drove out to the old murder house and. Of course! The van! Who's got the keys? Jimmy had them.
Of course.
Jimmy.
Damn, so now it's like. Do I tell them to get the keys? We already lost one person, bro. I'm not trying to lose nobody else, bro. It's gonna be okay, Carrie.
Okay. It's gonna be okay, Carrie.
Right.
We'll figure something out. Between all of you, there's gotta be a way to beat this. Just sit tight.
Okay? Maybe jump him next time.
Heather, shut up. If we do that, we're gonna get killed.
What'd she say?
Jeannie McPherson? Our intern Jeannie?
It's like, you know, it's a very small town.
And the smartest one out of all of us. She stayed in tonight. Forrest,
yeah, definitely the smartest.
We'll see what we can come up with. And, what? Scott, you're not any good at... And, no.
Boxing?
Chad. Out of all of us, you're not the one to...
Of course it's a Chad.
Everything okay?
No. He wants to be the hero, I bet.
Volunteering to do things they're just bad at. I think we can figure out what to do, but I don't think we can agree on who should do what. I think you'll have to be the tiebreaker.
All right.
These idiots are gonna get us killed.
But
I don't know the plans.
Oh, Forrest, I'll call you back.
They didn't.
I don't know anything about your friends.
Yeah, they didn't let me in on anything. Whatever.
These damn kids never learn.
Breathe, Peggy. It's okay.
Ugh, they do this kind of thing every year, Forrest. People get hurt.
All right.
I mean, which one Forrest is here?
We're gonna work out a way to save Carrie and her friends. Oh, this next one goes out to all the trapped kids out there.
Nah.
Peggy, you mentioned something about their friend working here? An intern?
Yeah,
Jeannie. Right, now I gotta go look
Seems
through
a
her
nice
desk.
Girl, but a bit head in the clouds, you know? Not sure why we took on an intern. We really didn't have the office space for one. Poor thing got tucked away in a dark corner somewhere downstairs, I heard.
All right, of course. I'll go see if I can find her desk. Hopefully she has something we can use.
Bro, what is finding the little girl's desk gonna do? Like, she just has notes on all her friends, downstairs. Bro? Okay, yeah, the stairs are this way. This don't even make no sense. There's not gonna be anything useful down here, bro.
Jeez.
Okay, well.
They tucked Jeannie away.
I guess I found her desk pretty easily. She got like horror movies and shit. Okay, let's put this back down. Gallows for life. She don't seem too smart, but with all the shit she got here.
Friendship quiz.
The fuck was that? All right, whatever. I'm gonna take this back up. All right. Wait, I gotta close the door. I'm sorry. This is just something I gotta do for my safety. You know what I'm saying? we might hear a creek open or something. It's not closed. There we go. All right, move. Yo,
You find anything that'll help us out?
Yeah, I found a friendship quiz with all these kids on it.
If you think that'll help, then good enough. Carrie's on line one, whenever you're ready.
I'm sorry, man. My sinus is just acting up today.
Okay, Forrest, shut the music off.
This is Forrest Nash, back again with an unlucky caller on...
Most likely to win a war for worst poker face.
Are you there?
Yes, we've got a plan, but we can't agree on who should do what.
You want me to be the tiebreaker?
Exactly.
Escape prison.
I'm ready. What's the first step?
Olympic athlete.
Okay. First things first, we'll need a spotter. Someone who can keep an eye on the killer. We'll need someone on the roof. It's gonna be a hard climb.
Alright, so we gotta go with Heather.
Heather, Kyle, and Hot David.
That's easy. You got it.
Heather's got this.
Yes, Heather. He picked you. Now please, stop talking about all your cheerleading trophies. Part two. The whistling man padlocked the gate back to the road. Before we drive out of here, we need someone to pick the lock.
Seth,
Scott all want to do it.
Seth for this one, because he's the most likely to go to jail.
Seth.
Seth, what are you talking about? I don't know that smashing into windows is really... God, fine.
I'm going to try to cut all these little...
That brings us to part three.
Hops and shit out.
Getting the van keys. I'll volunteer for this.
Carrie?
I don't know Jimmy as well as you guys, so... It'll probably be easier that way.
No.
Then it's part four.
Most likely to be his plan is ambitious for
His plan is well, it's ambitious.
Thank you.
You're doing great. What's the next part?
Part four. We need someone to lead the whistling man away. We need a fast runner. For this one, we're trying to decide.
So it's gonna be David, because Heather's going up to the roof.
Is it again? Hot David. Cynthia and Scott.
Yeah, go with David. Don't say hi. This nigga.
Yeah.
Just say David, bro.
You spend a lot of time running shirtless. You got this, Hot David.
Everybody's so calls a nigga Hot David. That's crazy.
We get the eyes on the roof.
Cynthia.
The runner distracts the killer while we grab the van keys and pick
Carrie.
Them up on the gate. Now the tricky part. The getaway.
Ooh.
Do I need
What's
this
plan there?
Well, we can't all outrun the whistling man.
Y'all are.
Let's use that against him. Part five.
Good luck.
We trick the killer into a trap.
Worst poker face?
Who you got?
We got Lisa.
It's definitely not Cynthia.
Tammy,
anybody's not Cynthia.
Cynthia.
We gotta go with Tammy.
Tammy.
Tammy, if you survive this,
worst poker face.
That British accent again.
Yeah, so it's gotta be. Yeah, just not Cynthia. That's it.
And then it's time to get out of here. Finally, part six. We need someone who can drive us through the woods and back to Gallows Creek alive.
No.
Who's our getaway driver? Should it be... Who we got? Chad? Scott? Cynthia? Whatever. Forrest, you know what to do.
For driving the van? They don't have one on that. So, Scott, Cynthia, Chad. What we got on any of them? Chad got a... He's got a decent poker face. Cynthia... She's on the escape prison list. Scott. I'm gonna go with Scott.
Scott.
I know we all love
mainly because
yes,
I think a guy would be better under pressure because girls like to panic. Don't hate me for that.
Thanks, Forrest. We'll just take a few seconds for ourselves.
I wish I could see how this shit played out, bro.
Sounds good. Talk to you in a sec.
That would be so cool if they had like a cutscene that showed how everything played out.
Actually sounded like a pretty good plan.
That would be really dope. I hope so.
I hope you're right.
Yeah, let's hope.
Now, I guess I'll just put the music back on. This video is gonna be late, man.
Oh, the kids are back already. Line one again.
I was really trying to get it up Friday, but I just wasn't in the right mindset. Like all day.
We're coming to you live with a bunch of teens about to flee a madman. Listener discretion is advised. Are you ready, Carrie?
We're good to go, Forrest.
All right, good luck, baby.
Good luck. And Godspeed.
It's the same thing.
Here we go, everyone. Spotter, to the roof. Go, Heather. She's off and away. All right, Renner. Get Spotter's signal. Spotter says go!
Go! That nigga took off. You just hear the footsteps.
Keys.
Sliced up?
You need to get the van keys.
His face is lying next to him, Forrest. He got cut. Oh, God.
That's crazy. Focus, though.
Focus. Breathe.
Right. The van keys.
Can't cry over a sawed off face when your life's on the line. Sound like he got David eyes.
God, hurry up, lock picking. Oh my God.
What did I do wrong?
Oh.
What did I do wrong?
It's going terribly.
Bro, keep going, bro.
You have to keep going.
Don't give up, Carrie. Don't give up.
Right. We just gotta keep pushing on. Time to try.
Where did I go wrong? What, bro? I picked everybody according to their skills.
Bait, get into position. Everybody else, hide.
Bruh. Okay, I didn't do nothing. Maybe, I don't know.
Act like your life depends on it.
I don't know.
Oh, there he is. He's buying it.
I don't know, bro. She sounds like she really in pain, though.
Oh, no. He knows.
Oh, my God, bro.
Damn it. Now, push the bookshelf over.
Why would you yell at? Just say it now. Or just do it.
Oh, my God. They both went through the floor. Spotter! You need to climb down now.
If Carrie survives, that's a dub. I don't care. All her other friends could die. If she survives, I feel like that's a win. Bro, ram that bitch. Okay, thank you.
Carrie?
Oh, what was that?
It's the whistling man. Drive! Now! Hold on!
We lost another grin.
No.
I'm sorry. Carrie? Let's just say what's happening.
Oh, we crashed. Everyone ran. My legs trapped. Forrest.
Damn. What happened, bro? I was doing so good. Cut the call, bro. It's over.
Carrie?
Let's go ahead and pick out the next song. Let's get, oh, she's still, alive. It's a good thing we didn't cut the call.
Carrie?
Is this the same song? He thought she was cute, Carrie. You got lucky.
Thank God you're okay.
Can you get somewhere safe?
Yeah. I can make it home. Thank you both for helping.
It's a dub. I don't care. Those other friends died. That's fine. That's absolutely fine with me.
It's my fault. Don't blame yourself.
No. It's... I need to get home.
Breathe, Carrie. You're okay now.
I'll call you when I'm somewhere safe. Talk to you then.
Well,
folks, that was a lot.
That was bad.
Our thoughts go out to the parents whose kids won't make it home tonight.
That was really bad.
Please stay inside and stay safe.
And parents, hug your kids extra tight tonight.
Here's a song for the girl walking home in the dark.
The world. I can't believe it, man. I was doing so good at first.
We had a call come in. When you're ready, shut the music off.
I always
forget
that.
Nash here. Listeners, we've got another caller live on 189.16.
The scream.
What's on your mind, caller?
Hey, Forrest. I just wanted to phone in and say that I think I speak for everyone when I say that you're providing a real service for Gallows Creek tonight.
Thank you, bro.
What you doing, man?
Well, I'm just doing my job, friend.
Thank you. Anyway, now get off my line. Oh my God.
What's your name?
We don't need to chop it up. We're still trying to keep people
man,
safe.
I'm good, thanks. I'm at my roller rink, trying to get everything ready for the Harvest Festival.
Roller rink, where is that at?
I had a guy from Starling Security here earlier installing the Starling 4000 system.
I just like to know where everything is at.
As for my name, my friends call me Roller Ricky.
I don't see that.
I now consider you a friend, my man.
No self-promotion,
don't allow
bro.
Self-promotion on my show.
Well, sorry.
Sounds like roller skating is more than just a job to you.
Wait.
Is this vocational?
I wasn't always.
Can I use these?
Once upon a time, believe it or not, I used to go by just Ricky.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Back then, things were pretty rough.
But I don't see the I still don't see the roller rink.
There was one guy. Anyway, some bad stuff went down.
Oh, it's over here.
I harbored a lot of guilt for a long time and turned to the bottle. I didn't really talk about it or even know how to talk.
He's at the end of Romero Street.
That bottle took the best years of my life. Or so I thought.
Cut the line.
It's never too late, Roller Ricky.
Cut the line.
I joined a support
group. Oh my goodness.
I opened up about my problems, and sharing that burden just took so much weight off. It's a long story from there, but I found roller disco. I learned how to have fun again, cutting loose and making shapes.
We have more important things to worry about.
Down, I get down. I'm finally free from it all, man. It's important just to talk to somebody. That's the first step. Ain't that right, Max?
At least you got a dog with him.
Aw, hello, Max.
We've gone to the dogs. He's a good boy.
There it is, folks. We've officially gone to the dogs.
Come on, Forrest. Max is the best guest we've had. Yes, he is.
Yeah, tonight.
He's not even here, Peggy.
Max is my emotional support dog. He's a rescue dog, but I always say he's the one that rescued me. He's the best dog a guy could ask
for. Probably that's a cliche.
Of course, the first thing I did was teach him how to skate. He's better than me now, a real pro.
Max can skate.
Yeah, man.
The first Some dogs can't skate. Done. Like, I've seen a video of, like, a dog skating.
But Maxie loves the rink, man. Is that another train, Maxie? Maxie loves trains, man. He's even got that special how to greet them.
Whatever. I'm gonna keep being a dickhead to this dude, because I want him off this
Maxie
line.
Maxie appreciates all the positivity you're throwing out, my man. You know, I'm actually hosting free skating lessons tomorrow at the festival. I think it's a great opportunity to give back to the
Cut
community.
The line.
Man, all this talk of skating's got me itching for a boogie. Before I switch my radio off for the night, could I request a song, Forrest?
No.
Something I can groove to, you know, something funky. It'll be me and Maxie's final boogie breakdown tonight.
What do you want?
We'll take it down a level.
I can do that. Thanks again for calling. You and Max, be safe now, okay?
Bye, Maxie.
He didn't even.
You got it, man. Whatever. Peace.
He didn't even give us a song.
This next one goes out to Roller Ricky and Max.
Enjoy. Which one is gonna be the funkiest? Let's go with the flow. Alright, this one's alright.
I really needed that call, you know, after everything.
Yeah, I get that.
I guess they wanted it to be like a lighthearted phone call to lighten the mood. Somebody come back. That shit just got on my nerves, bro.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
You were thinking about Max on skates, weren't you?
Well, would you look at that? Another caller on the line. What are the odds? Better take it.
Sorry about your song request, bro. You only listened to 30 seconds of it.
The Scream. This is Forrest Nash. How are you tonight, caller?
I'm doing okay.
Okay, it's Carrie.
I made it home safe.
Good.
Carrie!
Hey, I just wanted to thank you for doing what you could earlier. You know, even though not everybody made it, and,
yeah. Carrie made it, so like I said,
hey,
that's a dub.
It's okay. You were so brave earlier. You're safe now.
I wanted to ask you why. Why he didn't.
You must have some jugs on you or something, Carrie.
Why am I?
Why what, Carrie?
Why did he spare me?
Or maybe he wanted to follow you home.
Why let me go?
So did all the other friends die? I guess he wanted the
maybe
pranksters.
Maybe he only wanted to hurt the pranksters.
Maybe. Did he just think everyone was making fun of him? Did he always hate these hazing rituals? I mean, if he did, why wait all these years to... Why do this now?
These stupid hazing nights have to stop.
It is cold.
Carrie,
yeah.
You did so well tonight. Stay safe and rest. Help is coming to Gallows Creek. We just need to hold on.
Thanks, Peggy.
Dang, I don't remember what time it was when we first started.
Could I request a song?
But Shorty said she'd be back in like 6 hours.
Any song by Blast Processor. And
all right.
Thank you.
This next one goes out to Carrie.
Okay, well, Carrie's safe. So that's a good thing. So we're like, what are we, like,
you know,
4-1 now?
You know, what just said has really got me thinking.
About what?
The whistling man left her alone. Why? There must be a reason.
When it comes to masked whistling killers, I don't think a reason is a key part of their process.
Carrie just had
well,
to be fine as hell or
something,
bro.
I need to take a break. If you want to stretch your legs, now's the time. Just hit the Peggy button when you want to get back on air.
Yeah. Come on, Peggy. Let's keep this
going.
What am I going to do?
Alrighty.
I'm going to sit down on the couch?
Another segment, or...
Is that a caller?
For us. We have a caller.
You're through to 189.16, The Scream. What's your emergency?
Hello again, Forrest. Oh, that call with the teens.
Hello again?
Awful. Those poor kids. Still, I'm glad the girl didn't get hurt.
Me too.
Thanks for your concern. Are you in trouble? What's on your mind?
I wanted to ask you again to play my song, Forrest. You said you were going to play it, but you didn't.
My bad.
Your name was Dawn, right?
What, Peggy? Yes.
Oh, what song is it? Wait, it was a song that she threw outside.
I wanted to ask you again to play my tune, Forrest. Long Ride Home? You know, the one that Peggy said she threw outside the window?
If you heard that, bruh, we don't have it.
But we don't have that song. As you just said, Peggy threw it out the window.
But, Forrest, you do have it. It's just outside the window.
There's a serial killer on the loose.
Is she stupid?
I can't just go outside hunting for a record.
I'm really sorry, Dawn, but we just can't get it right now.
But wasn't the whistling man just at the old murder house?
Does it matter?
Miles from the station. It won't take you a second to grab it.
Cut the line. Yeah, try again tomorrow.
It's back tomorrow when this is all over, Dawn. And
I don't care.
Gladly play it for you then.
No, no, that won't do. Don't worry. I think I can bring you around. Forrest?
How?
Peggy, I'm calling with more than a request. I know something. I think I know who next.
What?
Are you serious?
Play my song, Forrest, and you'll find out.
I don't want to go look for this shit.
Here's some music for you while I think things over.
I'm gonna need to think this bitch over. Should I go and look for the song, bro?
She's serious about hearing that song, that's for sure.
Peggy, I mean, is she serious about...
I don't know, Forrest, but we don't really have a choice, do we?
Yeah, we kind of do.
She's telling the truth.
I don't care.
I don't want to go out there.
Forrest, someone might be in danger.
The whole town's in danger.
Being so damn curmudgeonly, I think you...
Stop it, Peggy. Just I'll go.
Bruh.
You're a good man, Forrest. I'll slide you the key to the fire door.
The fire door?
Wait. Our fire door has to be unlocked?
Yeah, it... you know, I never thought about it.
But that's pretty dumb.
We should talk to Reggie about that later. I'll hold the fort down while you're out. Maybe I'll even get a caller. That could be exciting.
Yeah, I'll be calling from...
9.16.
Alright, shut up.
With me,
shut up.
Peggy.
Throw me the key. Peggy looked tall as hell. I don't want to do this. Alright, so what is the fire door? This one?
That's not opening.
I guess it's just... What? I want to know what that door is to. We need some guns here or something. The fire door gotta be back here, right? I guess this is it. This is...
You know, I hope she'll be happy when I'm brutally murdered by the Whistling Man.
This is where the tutorial was at.
In the open? Alone?
Why did my shit just... I didn't hold up. I don't know why it just paused. I didn't push anything. Am I... Bro, they're not giving me, like, no type of hint. I really just gotta come out here and look for this shit. Bro, Peggy is gonna get the fucking hands when I go back inside, bro. Oh, me, Peggy. Hold up now. I thought I seen something. She could have told me what window she threw it out of. This is our building, right? It shouldn't be, like, down there type shit. This is our building. It had to come out of one of these windows. Okay, this is our building too. Pick it up.
Here it is. Long ride home.
Peggy, bruh. Oh my God, I'd beat the fuck out of Peggy and quit this job.
Of course, it locks behind me.
What the fuck?
Of course, the key doesn't work on this side.
Now what?
Fantastic. Maybe there's another way back in through the basement.
Door,
elevator, or something.
You want me to go down here? Can I open it? I can't even open this. I guess this is all a part of the same building. No, it's not, actually. You said the basement. Where the fuck? This is a different building. Supposed to climb through the window or something? Where the fuck am I supposed to go? So the power's gonna get cut off, probably. That's why they showed me this before. I'm gonna assume the power's gonna get cut off eventually. Okay, that scared the fuck out of me, I'm not gonna lie. That absolutely startled me. Now what? Am I missing something? Wait, this is open? No.
And that's broken too.
Okay.
Only the best for KFAM. See if I can fix this. Looks like a power issue.
Okay, so maybe that's what this is for.
The fuse box.
All right. Well, I guess there was a power problem, but not the way I thought it was. Is that what I needed to do? What is this?
Looks like I'm gonna have to hunt around for some new fuses.
Huh? What the fuck is he talking about? I gotta go look for fuses out here? I guess this is a fuse, isn't it? Why can't I pick it up? Why can't I pick this shit up? I had to be standing up to pick it up. That's stupid. Whatever. Can I throw this in the trash, actually? Whatever, it's out the way. Okay. At least the fuses weren't hard to find. They're kind of like obvious. So there's probably going to be another one down this way. Perfect. Does it matter where I put them at, though? Wait, this is a 30. Okay. So I got to put the 30s where the 30 goes. This is a 32. Does it matter? Or would it... I don't think the fuses would work how to, you know... I don't even know what this one was at first. But I threw that one over here. They all say 30. So do I need to find different fuses? Should I turn this back down?
Bingo!
Okay, we're good. Okay, we're good, we're good. This is still very, very creepy. Peggy. Oh my lord, Peggy. You're fired.
I could probably survive that fall.
Oh. Okay. Is there like a closed door button down here? Whatever.
Looks like the janitor's closet. What did Peggy say?
Do I need to go in here?
Clive?
I don't think there's nothing I need in there. Oh my god.
I wonder how the show's going.
It's probably not. What is this? It's locked. I bet Clive is the killer.
God, please let this be the last locked door.
I guess I gotta go through his office to find a door, right? I mean, a key. This is creepy, only because, like, the, what? Huh? Oh, shit. Can I keep this?
What the hell? Peggy is not gonna believe this.
Let me put this back on the board.
Ah, there's the beautiful key.
Oh my god.
I'm gonna get back to the studio now.
Clive is the fucking killer, bro. We know who it is now, though. It's 100% Clive, right? It's 100% Clive.
Yes!
Just like I said before, bro. He probably listens to the fucking... He probably listens to the damn... To us. Where the fuck am I?
Need a key.
Where am I? What? Yeah, Clive probably listens to the radio station. He hears all the calls going out. I'm telling you. I said that before. I said the killer probably listens to us. I don't want to go back outside again. We're about to get on the radio talking about we know who it is. It's Clive. And then he's going to come here and try to kill us.
And now for... Jesus, Forrest, you've been gone for ages. I thought something had happened.
You didn't think enough. You didn't come to see.
Clive the janitor might be Clive the murderer.
What?
I'll start from the beginning. The fire door locked behind me. So.
Yeah, it's a crazy story, man. Okay, it's 2:40. No idea what time the chief left.
Why
it's probably it had to be like 3 hours though.
Because the basement's creepy as hell, and I don't like standing around down there.
Fair. All right, let's run through this again. We have a creepy board you found in a creepy basement, made by our creepy janitor, who you think is the creepy whistling man.
Precisely.
Yep.
And on the creepy board are the names. Chuck Brody.
I should have took the paper. I should have took the
Rebecca
paper.
Allen and Aunt Williams.
Correct.
And you think one of these people will be the whistling man's, Clive's, next target?
That's right. And we've got to find.
I should have took the paper,
bro.
You
said there were four locations listed there too.
The hospital, I left the pepper because I don't know. I thought he'd come back and see it was missing or something.
Is it one of those locations?
That was so dumb. I should have took the fucking pepper, bro.
Any of the potential targets are at one of these locations tonight.
How am I supposed to figure that out?
You need any help?
How am I supposed to figure this out, bro? Okay, so he did take the paper. Okay. This nigga took the whole board, didn't he? Alright, whatever. Alright, so how am I supposed to figure this out? Wait a second. So, I can call Peggy if I want to. But let's actually try to figure this out. These are the four locations. These are the four people. We have something on all of them, right? Chuck Brody, Festival of Disaster, Big Wheel Breaks Free. It doesn't have anything. Wait, does it? It doesn't have anything about Chuck on here, so why would he be there? Monday, 1972. That's not the year, though. Okay, how about it say? Local doctor Kim Waller recommends. Okay, she's a doctor. So she might be at the hospital. Gallows Creek Power Station has 20 new staff. So she's probably at the hospital, right? I guess he could be at the power station. But we gotta find something about Rebecca. The trailer. Sale price. Tyler Wallace from info. That's not a name up here. I'm sick of being mocha celebrity. People so mean to me. I only stole a few cars. So I was about to rap it. It started to rhyme at first. Alright, so we're going to put her at the hospital. We're going to put him at the power station. Is there anything about the gas station? Something here. Christie's, is that a name? No. Has been sold to a man who won the lottery. Anonymous. Alright. How many names we got over here? Rebecca and Chuck. So if I had to put somebody at the gas station, I'd put Chuck because they did say a man who won the lottery. Is there something about the lottery on here though? Wait. Marriage announcement. Okay, I thought it was said retirement. The gas station and the trailer park, that's it. There's nothing, I don't see anything about a lottery out here. Local legend takes to Manhattan. She stole it. All right, so from what I read here, I'm gonna say Rebecca's at the trailer park. I'm gonna look a little bit more before I go call Pegs. But I'm kind of, I feel confident in this, but I'm just not too sure about this trailer park shit. It says contact Tyler Wallace, justice for festival victims. I don't know. All right, we're gonna go with this.
How's it going?
I think I got it. Can she help?
It's not going well. I could use some help.
Okay, let's review the basics. We need to work out who the next target is. There's four locations, right?
Four people?
And four people.
Yeah.
We need to figure out if anyone is at any of the four locations tonight.
So do we call them?
We can call them and warn them. There must be some connections between the notes.
That makes sense.
Great. Need any more help?
You're no help at all, really. Can you help more?
Sure. I think you should be methodical with this. Try grouping the notes by who they're about.
Bro.
You can also have a look at the dates and make a timeline. Maybe that will help rule out potential targets first.
Got it. Thanks, Peggy.
No problem.
I guess that helps a little bit. I ain't trying to do all that, though. I ain't gonna lie. Alright. Flu's... Does it have a date? Half of these shows don't even have the date. This one has a date. Okay, this is... I want to see somebody who's like a detective or something play this. And they probably figure this shit out for real. I'm gonna just go with what I got, though. If they die, they die.
How's it going?
I'm ready.
I'm ready, Peggy.
Are you sure?
I hope I got this right.
You only got one shot at this.
I'm sure. Hey, let's do this.
It is okay. What it is, man.
Then first, who do you think the target is?
Oh shit! I'm supposed to think. Okay. I thought I was gonna go by every person. I didn't know I had to pick who was gonna be next. Oh shit! Now I want to look some more. Okay. I'm gonna go with Kim. She seems the most important. I'm gonna go with Kim.
Kim Walker.
And where will I find them?
The hospital, hopefully.
The hospital.
Okay, I'm dialing. One moment.
Are we gonna go down every person, or were we just trying to figure out who's gonna be next?
Forrest, I'm through to the hospital, but...
But what?
They say there isn't anyone by that name there.
Well,
what? Then who?
Jeez!
It sounds like something blew up.
In the hospital?
Using bombs now?
Oh my god. The call board.
Huh?
One moment.
What?
Forrest, I'm getting so many calls. Just let me...
Just put somebody through.
I'm gonna take us off air for a moment.
I guess that was an L.
What's happening in there? Peggy.
I'm back.
He blew the gas station.
Gas station, Forrest.
Okay.
I spoke to the fire department and the hospital. The fire department is useless now, as you know.
Yeah.
And, the hospital's only ambulance was at the gas station.
What the fuck?
Forrest, you've got to say something on the radio. You have to tell the town. I'm putting us back on air. Now.
Why do I gotta do it?
I don't know how to tell you this, but the gas station's been bombed.
Please, everyone, stay safe. Stay inside. And
I'm bad at this.
Oh, just bring us into some music, Forrest.
Just blow this up.
Careful with this next track, listeners. It's dynamite.
Hey, that was funny. That was funny. Oh, this is bad. We're gonna... Wow. I want to see what the end is gonna be like. Because I fucked that
There's
up.
There's gotta be more in the basement to show us who Clive is targeting.
I'm not going back down there.
So we can get ahead of him. Stop the killings before they can happen. Forrest, we need to go back down.
We.
By we, you mean me, right?
Yep. Like I said,
I don't want to go back down there, bro. Fuck.
Maybe start with that creepy mannequin room you mentioned before. I still have a lot of questions about those, by the way.
Me too.
That bitch just waved at me. I don't like this, bro. I don't like scary shit. I really don't. I don't have no weapons, bro. Let me just grab something. Can I pick this up? Of course not. Let me take this pen, I guess. Yeah. Poke a motherfucker. And now the music's getting creepy again. Oh, let me turn these headphones down. I don't want to hear that shit. Oh my god. Having this pen does make me feel a little bit safer though, I'm not gonna lie. And that shit's still open. Alright. Let's actually look around, I guess. What am I looking for though? That nigga really took the whole board.
The key. Was this always here? I must have missed it when I brought everything upstairs.
Okay. Grab it. Basement storage. You got anything down here? No. He ain't got much, huh? Let's switch hands. I'm gonna keep that though. What is this? He would have some fun shit like this down here, weird ass nigga. Alright, let's check the storage room, I guess. Okay. That's back this way. What is he gonna have in his storage closet? Huh?
Hey, Forrest!
Peggy, give me some
warning. God damn.
Yelling down the intercom?
Sorry. Buzz the intercom when you find something and want to discuss it.
Where's the intercom? This? Okay. How does she know I was gonna be able to hear it though? What is this? What am I looking at? He got a manifesto.
I found a tape and a map down here.
A map of what?
Looks like it might be to somewhere in this storage area.
Weird. Well, maybe the tape will give us more information.
Let's listen.
Give it a play.
George Bellows, 1968. That's when this all began for me. Follow the maps. Find the tapes. I'll be waiting.
Wait.
What? I'm gonna take this pencil instead of this pen. Actually, that might hurt a little bit more.
Has Clive really been the whistling man for
this? Oh, I'm tripping.
He says I need
a screwdriver. Hell yeah.
Find the tapes. I guess that's what this map is about.
I think we need to see what else is hidden down here.
This is where he was pointing at?
Buzz the intercom when you found something.
This where he was pointing at in the picture? Yeah. Maybe. Maybe. Why don't I have a flashlight? I don't think nothing bad will happen right now, though, right? That nigga don't want to run up on me while I got this screwdriver. Oh, me, I'll poke that nigga. Something serious. Okay, no. Where the fuck are we? Let me turn this down a little bit more. It's getting creepy again. This side up. Is this important? I don't think so. Security system overview. Okay, that's interesting. Well, let me pull my shit back out. I don't like this shit at all, bro. Oh, it's another tape.
Small lacerations to arms, legs, and face. Typically obtained by running through foliage. Severe blistering to the feet, as though the deceased had been running without stopping.
Okay. So I get it. I need to just look for all these.
This looks useful.
Should I keep this? At 4 a.m. a call was received from a jogger Miss Sandra Sharp reporting that the body had been found washed up in the reservoir, I drove out to investigate and was able to identify the body at the scene as that of George Barrow. I contacted the coroner's office and then the boy's parents. They informed me that they had not seen him since 7 on the 2nd. Okay. Yeah, it's just telling you where the next tape is. I get it. Okay. Now we gotta find this. Okay. Was there a tape back this way? Yup.
Time of autopsy is 7 a.m. Cause of death is asphyxiation from drowning. The degree of rigor mortis indicates that the subject has been deceased for 5 hours. That puts the time of death.
Okay. This is so creepy, bro. Clive is so fired after this, bro. Oh, me, Clive is out of this bitch. That one didn't have a picture by it. Or maybe it didn't, I just didn't see it.
Toxicology results shows no signs of inebriation. However, a high amount of...
Can't see this fucking picture.
Indicating elevated levels of stress in the immediate moments before death.
What are... Okay. I like how you actually have to go to like a spot where it's more light before you can actually like see the picture. That's actually kind of cool. I guess it's a tape in that, in this. Can I click? They don't say it's nothing in there. Bro, why is it so much shit back here? We got more records. We should bring some of these upstairs. Oh, I thought he said it was in that.
Additionally, there appears to be a post-mortem injury to the arm. It looks like it was trapped in a car door.
Okay. Is there a picture? Yeah. This is so bizarre, bro. This is an intercom still? Can we use this to buzz Peggy? I don't know what the hell that is. Alright, hold up.
This has to be important.
The deceased is a Caucasian male, age 18. The cause of death is established to be drowning, as shown by the signs of asphyxiation. Abrasions were found on the knuckles, likely from getting into fights in the past. Matches with known history of deceased being aggressive. No other injuries were observed, and from the coroner's opinion, there is no evidence of foul play. Additionally, the preliminary toxicology report indicates the deceased had a high level of alcohol in her blood. Okay. Went swimming or drunk and died. That's what they're saying.
It is the coroner's opinion that the subject likely feared for his life and was chased, resulting in a fall from a height into a body of water where he hit his head, was knocked out, and drowned. Following that, he was moved.
Dr. Shaw, we need to have a talk. Is that recording? Shut it off.
This is getting deep, bro. You see, I still got my screwdriver. This ain't going nowhere.
I'm probably dead.
Ooh, a new vinyl for my collection. What the?
I've got subscriptions to newspapers all over the country. A few weeks ago, I noticed headlines cropping up in those papers, one after the other. Each headline about a murder. Each murder, the death of someone I knew. almost 20 years ago. And each one drawing closer to Gallows Creek. Drawing closer to the anniversary.
I'm about to play this one again, okay?
None of us are innocent. But I don't think we deserve killing. All I hope now is that I can save some folk from the worst.
So it's not Clive. He killed the boy that drowned. Maybe not.
But that's past.
He put that to rest immediately.
Now, there's more I could say than I should say. But my employer made it clear that my family would pay a high price if I ever spoke out. So, hopefully I've said enough for you, listener. Whoever the hell you are. Start putting the truth together.
What the hell?
Listening to this.
Peggy is not gonna believe this.
I'm probably dead. I'm a man who likes to stay informed. I've got subscriptions to newspapers all.
Wait. I don't know if I just missed something, but I'm still kind of confused. Should I talk to Pegs through the intercom or just go back up? So it's a map down here too.
What have you found, Forrest?
A lot.
It's an autopsy tape. Doesn't say for who, but I think it must be for George.
Poor George. Young.
Something's bugging me, Peggy.
What do you mean?
I swear I recognize the voice of the woman talking on the tape. I just can't place it.
Seriously? Do you think you've met her before?
I don't know.
I didn't recognize the voice.
I just got here recently. I don't know. Found another tape. It talks more about how George died.
What did it say?
It sounds like he was running for his life. Sprinting through trees and bushes, getting cut up all over.
What would drive someone to do that?
I'm not sure yet. There's also a tape about a toxicology report. There were no signs of drinking or that he was on anything.
But the,
what?
They said
but
that
everyone said he went swimming drunk and drowned.
That's exactly what one of the papers said too. But the toxicology report did say it wasn't in there.
I found a written autopsy report.
What does it say?
According to that, it's just like you said at the start. George drowned after getting drunk. Said he liked to fight, too.
But that contradicts the tape.
I know. And I think I know why. There's a note with the report that says, I'm sorry I made you do this, Virginia.
So did I find everything that I was supposed to find?
Report, then Virginia must be our coroner. Wait, the caller from earlier. When we had to call the takeout restaurants. Wasn't her name Virginia?
Was it?
We need to call her back once we finish down here. It looks like she might know something about what's going on. I found a tape that introduces a new detail to the story. Post-mortem injury. Apparently, his arm got caught in a car door.
A car door?
I think I found everything.
Yeah, after he died. How do you suppose they can tell?
How can they tell? I'm a radio producer, not a coroner.
I don't know. They can tell. It's really crazy.
Doesn't mention it at all.
How did his arm get trapped in a car door after he died?
Somebody moved the body?
When the police collected his body?
That wouldn't happen.
I guess someone else must have moved him.
Because the police wouldn't put him in like in a car. They put him on a gurney.
Eventually found.
But the report. What is going on here?
It's a cover-up.
We found a police report. Mentions a friend from earlier. Sandra Sharp.
Sandra. The jazz runner?
That's right. She found George's body washed up at the reservoir.
The reservoir?
Yeah? What's strange about that?
George got cuts from running through foliage, right?
It wouldn't be by the reservoir.
There's no forest yeah. there. Also, how did it wash up at the reservoir?
What do you mean?
Reservoirs don't have tides.
Yeah, they're just
that's
body.
That's what the police report said.
Huh.
It's not possible, though. I did a school
that's
project
a good
on
point.
Reservoirs and got an A. But, yeah, not important right now. The important thing is that it doesn't...
Yeah, because it's not like a lake. Look,
what do you suggest?
What is like, I don't know.
That the body was originally found somewhere other than what the report suggests. That the sheriff tried to cover it up, but accidentally let something slip?
Something like that.
We are in too deep.
I think.
Well, Sheriff Matthews wrote the report. If he hadn't been eviscerated, we could have asked him.
True.
Where is the reservoir?
Sandra is still alive. Once we're done down here, we should give her a call.
In another tape, the coroner comes to the same conclusion as I did. George was running from something.
Maybe an animal?
Maybe, but then there's this next bit, where the coroner thinks he was moved post-death.
So she agrees with us.
At the end of the tape, someone burst in and demanded Virginia stop recording.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was Clive.
That wasn't Clive.
It's starting to make sense now. This is a conspiracy to cover up what happened to George.
I think I found Clive's last recording. I think Clive might be gone.
So he's not the killer.
I found a confession. Not for any killings, but for playing a part in covering up George's death. He left this behind.
This is too deep.
He died. He hoped someone would find it.
Do you think the whistling man already got him?
Possibly. We've had a lot of callers tonight, but
Clive wasn't one of them.
Maybe not every victim made it to the phone, you know?
Yeah?
We don't know how many there really are.
Christ, Forrest, that's dark.
It's true.
But Clive said he had read about other murders in other towns, and that the murders were all folks who knew about the incident. And the killings were getting closer to Gallows Creek. He said he wanted to do something good for once.
The board in his office. He wasn't tracking people down to kill them.
He was tracking the killer.
He was tracking them down to save them. Ugh, why didn't he just come out with all of this?
Really?
He said his employer threatened his family if he spoke out about any of it.
His employer?
That's us, right?
He orchestrated the cover-up?
His employer?
Oh, Clive.
He works for the fucking radio.
Sorry for thinking you'd killed all those people. Do you think you found everything?
I'm gonna say yeah.
I think so.
Forrest, what's going on here?
Someone wanted that boy's death to seem like an accident. And they hired Clive to make it look that way.
Come back upstairs when
you ain't
gotta
tell me twice.
Figure out our next step.
You don't have to tell me twice. I was ready to go upstairs. That shit creepy. I should listen to the tapes again, but fuck that.
Thank God you're back, Forrest.
Let me keep this up here with me, though.
Stuff to pat
yeah, now I got a weapon.
Peggy,
yeah.
You work in radio.
Forrest, I'm stressed. I mean,
is there a new one up
really?
Here? Is this
How
what I found?
How are we supposed to keep a show going with all this happening?
No, this is the new one, yeah. We're gonna play this. Did I get it? No, I didn't get the right shit. It's our job, shit.
This is our job, Peggy. We gotta do it.
You're right.
This is a new one too, isn't it?
What's the plan now?
Is that the one that was outside?
We should call Virginia back.
All right.
I think
I'll
that
get
is.
Her on the line.
Yeah.
Hello again, Gallows Creek.
Stop
this is Forrest Nash.
I want to hear this.
We're circling closer to the truth behind tonight's events. To this end, we're calling back one of.
It looks like an eye. That is fire.
Virginia Sullivan.
Plunker?
Who's this? Is it you? Goose?
They still with her?
Plunker! It's Goose!
Goose! Goose! Goose! Goose! Goose! Goose! Where are you? Get your ass here! The party has moved!
Oh, cool. Where's it moved to?
This old lady's house. Oh, she's pretty cool, though. She said we could raid her liquor cabinet if we stayed and protected her. Of course, we're not drinking anymore. We're staying sharp in case that whistling turd turns back up. The old lady might need our help.
Let me talk to her, bro.
And of course. Hey, could you put me on with the old lady? You know, should check if it's cool for me to drop by.
Oh, there's that goose respect we love. I'll grab her now.
These people are dumb.
Hello? Is this Goose?
Hey, Dr. Sullivan.
Who is this?
Hey, Virginia, it's Forrest. I'm glad you're still okay.
Oh.
What is our radio Forrest. Station number again?
Sorry.
189.16, right? Yeah. We need to talk,
sorry
baby.
To hear that, but listen, hey, we need to talk.
What about?
We're calling because we think you can help us understand why this is happening tonight.
Me? What would I know?
Clive.
Does the name Clive mean anything to you?
Clive? No. I don't know that name. What are you asking about this for?
Yo, cut the shit, lady.
You mentioned that name earlier when you called us the first time.
Did she?
I don't know what I said then. I was petrified, Forrest.
Clive's the janitor at our station, and we know you spoke to him in the past.
Forrest, please. You don't know what you're doing. He'll come for me.
Virginia,
we can set him up.
It's okay. Clive won't be coming after you.
We think Clive's dead.
Dead? But isn't he? He's the Whistling Man, Forrest.
No. Yeah, why do you
why
think
are you
that?
Why are you so certain Clive's the Whistling Man?
Because he... All those years ago, he...
Why didn't you say that earlier if you thought he was the Whistling Man?
He's gone. We found evidence to suggest he... Well...
And we found your autopsy reports for George Barrow.
At the same time...
I saw him destroy them.
Clive could have just recorded all that shit as like a cover-up to throw the police off his tracks.
We found them, and we know it's related to what's happening tonight, which is why we called you. Why did you write a false report?
I... All right. One day, I came into work to find a boy on my slab.
On the slab is crazy.
As I finished the autopsy, this man, Clive...
So it was Clive.
He just burst in, and he started making demands to give over the reports, to falsify what I found. Of course I said no, but... Well, when someone wants to make you do something, they can use the carrot or the stick.
That's a good point.
For me, he used both. You see, my sister is sick. She has a chronic condition that's never going away. It's expensive to treat, and it was getting to where I couldn't afford it. And Clive promised me that his employer would pay for my sister's treatment. If I did what he said, and that if I ever spoke about this, he'd beat me to within an inch of my life. I don't know why he had me do it, but my sister needed me. You have to understand. She
I understand.
Needed me.
We understand.
Speak for yourself. It's okay.
Thank you, Virginia. That was brave.
God, I just want this nightmare to end.
This will help end it, Virginia. Thank you.
Stay safe, Virginia.
I mean, I understand.
Virginia's tied up in all of this.
I do the same thing for my sisters.
Keep quiet about George's death.
I wouldn't even think about it.
Why cover up these details? Well, we know Sandra was involved in George's death. Do you want to call her?
Sandra?
All right, but before we go asking questions...
Is that a name? I saw Sandra on somewhere.
I want to ask. Is that fair?
Yeah, we need to ask her about finding the body.
That's the one who found the body.
She's the one who discovered it, but something just doesn't add up.
100%. She knows more than she's saying.
I wonder what she's hiding.
We'll hopefully find out soon. Anyway, just be careful when you're talking to her. Don't push too hard. We don't want her to hang up.
I'll be careful.
All right. Calling her now. Hopefully she's at her jazz
studio. I really want to hear this shit.
Aha! We'll wait. Forrest, you're through.
Hello, this is Sandra at Jazz Pizzazz Jazz Studio. Who is this?
Hello again,
isn't it
Sandra?
3 in the morning?
It's Forrest Nash of 189.16.
The Scream.
And you're live on air.
Oh, I always thought folks called into a radio show, not the other way around.
You're right, for the most part.
What can I do for you?
Well, we're trying to understand what's behind the attacks tonight. We had a few questions.
Why, Forrest, of course. Heck, after the way you saved my life.
We saved her life?
Yes to just about anything you asked.
Let's ask why you were targeted.
Why the Whistling Man might have targeted you.
Ha! As far as I could tell, he was just a knife-wielding psycho with...
So is the Wilson man still trying to cover up the...
Right.
So he's still trying to cover up the kill.
He might be chasing specific people. People who know about the death of a boy named George.
Yeah. Oh,
I don't know anything about that. Sorry.
Sandra, we know you found George's body. We have the police report.
I don't know what you mean.
It's okay, Sandra. We know.
You do? You know about?
Yes. Of course.
This studio is my life. After I found the body in the river, I couldn't lose my studio. Do you understand?
Sure. Okay. I understand.
When the rent just kept going up, he said he'd stop if I just needed to keep quiet. And everything would be okay.
Sandra, who was he?
He was...
Give us a name.
He said...
Oh my god.
If I told everyone I found the kid in the reservoir instead of the river, he... I'm sorry. I can't do this.
Did I push too hard?
I don't think that could have gone any better.
I don't think so either.
You truly did great, Forrest.
Well, folks, if anyone out there has any thoughts on what's going on tonight,
call in and let us know.
Call in.
That's good timing. We've got a call waiting just this second.
All right.
Welcome to 189.16 The Scream with me, your host, Forrest Nash.
Hi, Forrest.
This is the pizza guy, bro.
Out of the blue with everything happening tonight.
Count Dracula.
If you could send this special birthday message to my uncle.
Fuck it.
You know what? I'd welcome a change of pace. I'd be glad to.
Thank you, Forrest. He's my Uncle Ronnie.
Hang up. Hang up. It's the pizza dude, bro.
But since he always had salt
Hang up. It's the pizza dude, bro. I'm sick of this nigga, bro.
Always called him Pepper.
Thanks for the history lesson.
It's the pizza dude, bro.
Happy birthday. You'd like to say to Mr. Pepper. Oh my god, damn it!
Yes! Well, I'm taking the best birthday deals and party packages here at Pony's Pizza. Starting at your...
You son of a bitch! Stop calling!
Sorry, Forrest.
Okay.
Let's just move on. We've already got another caller on.
Ponty was needed, man. Okay, Ponty was definitely needed, bro.
16, The Scream. I'm Forrest Nash. You're on the air, caller.
He said lighten up the mood, Ponty. Thank you.
Caller.
Oh, man, that nigga Ponty, bro. It's not like he's laughing.
Ponty.
Ponty's Pizza always delivers. Come rain or sleet or whistling man, we'll be there.
Is Ponty the killer or something?
Forrest?
Bro, hang up. Is he still on the line?
Are you okay? Forrest?
I hope the whistling man gets him with his own pizza slice.
Jesus, Forrest?
Yo.
Sorry, that was too much.
It's okay. It's been a high stress night. Not for tonight, anyway. I think he's spent for now. We've got another call. Whenever you're ready.
Yo, pa. Yo.
We have a call waiting.
Shut up, Peggy. Oh,
folks,
yo.
Don't spend your money on Buddy's pizza. That's all I'm going to say about that. Moving along.
Yo. Welcome. I'm sorry. 189.16. Posse was the best character, bro.
With me,
I didn't like him at first. He got it.
Is calling.
Well, hello again, Forrest.
Done.
You want to hear the song again?
I'm sorry I didn't play your song.
I did play that fucking song.
Going on. But please.
Never mind that now. First, I'm calling.
I swear I played that song, bro.
Are you in danger?
Oh, I sure am.
Do you mean...
Yes, he's after me now.
You?
I think so, he must have heard me on the radio helping you.
You did say you knew some. Helping?
Helping? You didn't exactly help.
Maybe.
She didn't give us any information.
I was out following a lead, trying to work out who would be next, after Chuck.
And what happened?
And I started to feel like I was being followed. I came back to my apartment building, but this newfangled security system has me locked out.
I seen something about a security system in the basement.
Inside.
Don't you have a key to get in?
Only for the apartment door. The front gate requires an entry code.
You don't know the fucking code, bro?
The future is electronic, I guess. I need that code to get inside.
Which apartment block do you live in? Maybe one of our listeners lives there too.
It's the new Woodside apartment building between the town hall and the trailer park. But I doubt any of your listeners live there.
What the fuck?
I don't have many neighbors.
It's a train?
Sounds like a prime piece of real estate.
The sound really carries at night. Shit.
Yeah. I did not mean hit that.
Not a dog person.
No, I'm not. My neighbor's dog.
I did not mean to cook
that
one.
Muscle that thing in. Oh. And now he's blasting David Scopo out of his window.
Go to his fucking house.
He's coming down the street. I don't think he's seen me yet.
Go to your neighbor's house.
What's your neighbor's name?
I don't know my neighbors, remember? Please, I need to get in.
Yeah, get his attention.
Get your neighbor's attention?
That the whistling man will see me, Forrest. I can't do that.
What's the name of the security system?
There's a sticker on the box. It says Starling Security 4000. There's a keypad, and it looks like it wants a six-digit number.
That's a lot of digits, bro. Hey, she might be dead, bro.
Sounds like that would be hard to remember.
Yes, very hard, especially on a night like this.
Yeah, of course. Don't worry, Don.
She's gonna die.
Forrest, I knew I could.
Yeah, she's as good as dead.
I'll sit out of sight. Call me back soon.
I gotta go back downstairs again.
All right, folks. Here's a little tune for you all to enjoy.
Okay.
While I try to break Don into her apartment.
Well,
you were pretty quiet there, Peggy.
Forrest, was it just me, or was there something?
Yeah, it wasn't just you. Something was weird about that.
Yeah. Well, tell you what. We have a Starling 4000 or whatever here at KFAM. Clive bought one for the station. Maybe we can find something to help.
Of course, I gotta go back.
I'm not sure who.
Down there.
But to help someone.
All right. Well,
okay.
At least we know the whistle man's not here, so I ain't really gotta be worried about it.
Somewhere, Clive probably has the papers for the Starling 4000.
I saw that shit when I was in his basement. I didn't know it would come in handy though. I probably should have figured it would. It is alright. Nope, wrong way. Here we go. Wait, I came in here. Let me turn this shit back down. This music, man. The creepy music just makes everything worse. Was it this way? Or was it in his office? I don't even remember. I should have checked the other way first. But this way is smaller, so. It was not this way. Nope. Alright. Gotta check the other side. This game, bro, I like it, but damn, I hate this creepy shit, bro. I knew it was in here. Is it me? Does it look brighter now? There was definitely a paper with all that shit on it, though. Is this the security box here? No. Where the fuck was it? Should I just wing it? I might just wing it again, no cap. You know, if another one dies, it is what it is. But I definitely saw a paper about the security system earlier, bro. Is it this way? Starling 4000. Just take us upstairs.
User manual. Ah, these codes should come in handy.
Perfect. Entry code. Should I just give her this entry code? Definitely can't give her the alarm test deactivation code. Where am I at? Oh, okay. I like made it back up the steps like just on autopilot. I don't even pay attention. No, please change these codes immediately. It's a boring imperfect. Okay. So alarm test warning, this will set off all security measures. Let's not hit that one. Let's just try the entry code, I guess.
Welcome back, Forrest. Find anything?
The Starling 4000 security manual. It's got a bunch of codes.
Good. And did you find anything else?
Nothing, except the manual.
All right. Well, I'll get Dom back on the line then, Forrest. I'll let you take it from here.
Thanks,
all
right. Betty.
Line one, whenever you're ready.
Don, are you there? This is Forrest Nash from 189.16.
The Scream.
Oh, thank God you're back. I've been so afraid. What's the code to the gate?
I don't know how I'm supposed to just know that.
The code is 715-914.
They might have changed it, though.
Forrest.
It didn't work. Did it work?
Forrest. What did we do?
She just laughed.
I don't know, actually. I guess we'll find out.
Forrest.
She laughed and hung up.
Evening caller, you're live.
All right, so Dawn. So Dawn is a problem.
Forrest. The psycho's somewhere in the roller rink, dude. I just saw a shadow.
Okay, so Dawn is a problem.
Forrest.
Dawn is a problem.
Come back.
Let your dog handle that nigga, bro.
Find my rifle, man. It's... I don't want to hurt anybody, but I can't let anything happen.
Did the dog just get shot?
Maxie.
R.I.P. Max. Something told me not to give her the fucking code too. Wow, that fucking bitch. Something told me don't give her the code, bro. I should have gave her the fucking alarm, bro. Wow.
So the whistle
is there a want one here?
Is a woman?
Yeah, I'm not gonna say that.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna say this.
Fuck it. A while ago.
Yeah, sure, Forrest. You just never mentioned it.
Yeah, that was a lie.
You spoke to her multiple times.
I knew she wasn't right.
I'm just gonna.
Is that
yeah.
right, Sherlock?
I did play the Sherlock Holmes game, so you know I'm pretty good.
To get me outside?
Maybe, but how? She didn't know the song was outside to start with.
Well, maybe she That's did. Right.
She never actually attacked me out there.
So? What now?
I guess I should make an announcement. We do have new info.
Okay, kill the music and you can make the announcement. Okay, you're live.
So are we starting this hurt on? Or is she just out killing people too?
This is Forrest Nash here. I hope you're all safely locked inside.
Did she whistle?
Listening to that last call, you might be wondering what to make of it all. Here's our take. We now believe the killer is actually a woman. One who might manipulate you into letting her in before she attacks you.
Our neighbors look out for each other, stay safe. Nah, fuck that.
Sad to say, but it's time to trust no one. The killer was calling themselves Dawn.
This could be a fake name.
This could be a fake name. If anyone needs help or you have info on the killer, please call in. You folks have my new number, right? It's 911. Hopefully, our next caller can help shed some light on our killer.
That is crazy.
Hey, we had a call come in.
Okay, folks, time to take a call. This is Forrest Nash, and you're listening.
Please help me. My name is Casey Moore. I'm at 25 Nancy Drive. My best friend's been stabbed. He's bleeding everywhere. I don't know what to do. Please help me.
Somebody's been stabbed. Can you tell me what happened?
He got stabbed.
We went out at the reservoir. We were heading back to his place when we heard this whistling all of a sudden. He just started freaking out. He screamed at me, told me to hide. I'd never seen him like that. And I just panicked and ran and hid in a bush.
Oh, no. Forrest.
Then what happened?
He went up the road and talked to someone. I couldn't really hear or see anything. It sounded like...
I think it's two killers.
The person. And they just stabbed him.
I think it's two killers.
Casey, was he talking to a woman?
I don't know. They had a mask and wore all black. That's all I know. Please, we need help here.
What the fuck am I supposed to do?
I need to know. Where did the masked person go? Wait, why didn't she make sure he was dead?
I don't know. I think I heard them.
If she's listening to her radio,
it's not so funny now, is it?
She knows where to go back to now.
Please, he needs to get to the hospital. I can't drive, so we need an ambulance.
The ambulance is like.
The ambulance was destroyed in the explosion at the gas station.
And the gas station has flat. No, not the fire truck has a flat tire.
What's your friend's name, Casey?
It's Jason. Jason Parker.
Can you tell us where Jason was stabbed?
In the stomach, obviously.
And he stabbed him again in his leg when he was on the ground, and it's... Oh, the knife is still there in his leg.
Don't pull it out. Don't pull it out.
Patch us through to the hospital.
On it. Phoning St. Gabriel's now. Switch to line 2.
Hello, St. Gabriel's Hospital. How can I help you?
Hi, this is Forrest Nash from 189.16. We have the stab victim.
Why does he keep introducing the radio station?
He's been stabbed in the stomach and the leg. He's bleeding heavily.
Oh god, I'm sorry. But the ambulance is, well, you know.
Yeah.
I know, but please, we need something or he's going to die.
Forrest, listen, you're going to have to get him here.
How?
We need to see him and we can't get there ourselves right now.
We don't have any way to drive him right now. And even if we did,
I mean, she said he was in a garage and they ain't got no car?
All right, listen. We need to buy him time to get here. That means stopping the blood first and then finding someone to stabilize him. To stabilize him, you really need someone with first aid training. Do either of you have any?
No.
Nope.
Me neither.
Damn it. I'm really sorry about this.
Nice.
I have other patients who can't wait. All I can do is talk you through the procedure as quick as I can and then leave the rest to you.
All right, let's listen up. Listen up. Hell yeah. Yeah. We can handle this.
I'm sure we can handle it.
Come on.
Okay, from the top. If he's bleeding out, then you need to get him comfortable and try to stem the bleeding.
Okay.
Lay him down. Apply continuous pressure directly.
I already knew most of this.
Areas. When the bleeding slows, get a clean cloth of some kind and hold it over the wounds.
Mm-hmm.
Get them comfortable.
This is easy.
Apply pressure. Clean cloths when slowed.
She's taking notes.
Got it. I think.
You said he was stabbed, right?
Yeah.
If the object he was stabbed with is still in him,
leave it.
Don't take it out.
I knew that.
It's stopping the worst of the bleeding right now. If anything, you should secure it so it stays where it is.
I wouldn't have thought of that. It makes sense, though. God, that was a lot of info. But I think we can handle this.
Glad you got it so far.
I didn't even need her to walk me through this. I knew all of this. We got it. I can't keep up. Keep going. Are you sure they can't?
This is a lot to remember. Are you sure you can't stay on the line?
It wasn't an option, but alright, we got this.
Please, just let me continue. If he's lost a lot of blood, he may enter shock. If he does, act fast. If you apply a cloth and it's bleeding through, don't remove it. Just apply another on top of it.
Okay.
If it's safe, elevate his legs to get blood circulating to his vital organs. Try to keep him warm. Get him to rest and reassure him. We need the patient to stay calm.
All right.
I didn't know some of that.
Bandages, elevate his legs, keep him warm and calm. This is a lot.
I'm really sorry. That's as much as I can give you right now. Try to stop the bleeding. Find someone to get him stabilized and get him here as quick as you can.
Yes, ma'am.
Good luck.
All right, Forrest. Casey's still on line one.
Hello? Forrest, are you there?
Yeah. All right, how is he?
I'm here. How is Jason doing?
Badly. He's still bleeding. I need help. I've been putting pressure on his stomach wound since you left, but he's still bleeding. I don't know what to do.
That's good, Casey. The nurse said to do that.
What about the knife in his leg? It's gotta be hell. Should I pull it out?
Don't touch the knife.
No, don't touch the knife. The bleeding will get worse if you pull it out.
Are you sure? I'm sorry. I'm gonna stop making suggestions.
Yeah, just listen to the pros,
don't worry,
babe.
Casey, we're a team here.
Don't say that.
We're all
I'm
gonna
later.
Get Jason
follow my orders.
This. Casey, is his leg wound bleeding right now?
I hate looking at that knife. Yeah.
Wrap it up. You gotta wrap it.
His stomach is worse, though.
All right, we need to secure the knife.
I think we need to secure the knife so it doesn't move around. Do you have anything you can tie around it?
Yeah. There's some laundry piled up on top of the dryer, some cloths on the hood of the car, and what else? I guess I've got my jacket.
Go for the laundry.
Look in the laundry for something like a towel or a shirt. Hold that over the wound.
Okay. Looks like I'm gonna have to buy you some new whites, Jason. Here we go.
It's not time for jokes.
Yo,
put Jason on the phone, bro. Who was it?
I'm putting pressure on his stomach again. Oh, I'm starting to think we might make it.
Forrest, can I have a word?
What's up?
Casey, I'm gonna have a quick word with Peggy. Keep putting that pressure on, and let us know when the bleeding is under control.
I should have told her ass to wait.
You're doing great.
But what if something happens?
We'll still be here. Just shout if you need anything, and we'll be there. I promise.
Okay. I'll wait. Jason, please be okay.
Peggy, talk.
What's up, Peggy?
We can't stay on the line with her all night. Dawn is still out there. What if other people need us?
Bro, we'll make this quick, bro.
She's probably on her way to her next target right now.
Exactly. And you heard the nurse. We need someone there with training who can stabilize him. He's got to get to the hospital somehow.
Any suggestions?
Any suggestions, Peggy?
I might. A little before you started working here, KFAM did a mandatory first aid training course. Me and Karen missed it because we were away on a producer getaway.
You skipped it, didn't you?
Yep.
Never mind.
It doesn't matter.
So, how does KFAM's first aid course help us?
Casey said they're at 25 Nancy Drive, right?
Yeah. Why?
They put up a bunch of cheap houses around there about 10 years ago. So a bunch of people
that might have been one of those.
Station live around there.
Do you think any of them could help Casey and Jason?
Probably, but I don't know who lives there. And since I missed the training day, I don't know who knows first aid.
Could you call them and ask?
I don't know everybody's numbers.
I gotta go look for numbers, bro.
I've only ever called Karen. Everybody's personnel info is probably in Reggie's office.
Got it. I'll look through their files in Reggie's office. It's a life or death situation. I'm sure they won't mind.
Who is Reggie?
But there are a couple of problems with that.
Go on.
It's sensitive information, so Reggie probably locked it in his safe.
Great. Great. Do you have any idea what the combo for the safe could be?
Not a clue. Reggie's a serial note taker, though. Maybe something in his office will give it away. Right. There is something else.
I'm not gonna like this, am I?
Have you ever heard the future is floppy?
No.
Peggy, what the hell are you talking about?
I'm talking about floppy disks. Floppy disks are like these futuristic things that have information on them.
Floppy disks went out of style fast as hell.
You put them in a computer and they do something.
Peggy, I know what a floppy disk is.
I don't think I've ever used one.
Anyway, Reggie decided that the future is floppy and started phasing out our physical records and replacing them with these floppy disks. I imagine it's the same for our personnel files.
That's good to know. Since we haven't heard anything from Casey, I'm guessing Jason's okay for now. I'll check out Reggie's office and see what I can find.
You'll need a key for that. I'll just slide it under.
That might be the office on the other side. Man. Why does Peggy have the key to everything? I'm good.
Good.
What the fuck you mean? There's more to do.
To the office, what? So you'll hear me over the intercom.
Wait, I gotta go downstairs? So what is this?
Locked tight.
Okay, so this is offices everywhere. Reggie's office is gonna have some crazy shit in it too, I bet. You know, this could have been such a nice night. But nope, we gotta deal with everything. So this is his office. Why does everybody have a map of the town? Clive, if you're reading this, stop stealing my post-it notes. That's funny. Overdue, as you need those tapes are right now. Can't flip this. Can I put this in? Nope. I don't know what that was.
Looks like I need a 4-digit code.
Very important date. X forever. It's gotta be something, right? So Reggie got first day certified. You can't read the rest of these. Is there anything else in here? Anything with a date? I'm about to just try 1987. Unless this was a different year, wasn't it? I'm gonna try 1987. Cause none of this other stuff really has too much on it. Floppy disk. Where do I put this? How do I use this? The file cabinet's not open. No drawers on this side. Okay, that didn't work. I had to try though. But how do I use this disk? Please insert floppy disk. Insert it where?
Could this be it?
This doesn't have any numbers on it. Takes place 1107. I don't need to see anything else. That was the first number I saw. Let's try it.
Nice.
Easy. What? Alright. Do I have to take the other disc out? I guess so. Wait, I forgot the road I'm looking for.
Apparently, I'm a lone wolf type.
What are you doing? I didn't even read the name on this. I don't know why. I should have read the name. I just grabbed this one.
And you're more interested in you.
Yeah, that's my bad.
I need to focus on possible candidates. I can read the rest of this later.
The fuck was that? What the fuck? This is... 14 NC Drive. Is this the number we're looking for, though? I mean, the street? I don't remember the street. Alright, so John lives on NC Drive. Let's try to remember. Refused to engage a first aid trainer. He was a war medic. So John might be alright. Okay, so I'm gonna try to. The people that might be candidates, I'm gonna put them in the chair. Hopefully it's only like two. I feel like Nancy Drive was right. Axe down lane, this is wrong. I don't even need to look at that one no more.
Hey Peggy, I think Reggie's on to you and Karen. Maybe don't bring those little drink umbrellas into work for a while.
Okay, Peggy.
Why are you reading my file?
Yeah, I need to read this shit, cause I'm just grabbing shit.
You're right. I'm sorry.
My bad.
We need to focus on possible candidates. I really shouldn't have read both. We're in a hurry.
Nancy Drive. This is closer. It's 22. So this one's a lot closer. Wait, did this one have the? Karen was really stepped up her duties. Karen was the person she skipped with, though, right? Karen stepped to monitor Peggy. I think this would be really good for Peggy. 5 days starting to affect Peggy. Yeah, so Karen is useless. It's gonna be this dude. Yeah, it's gonna be this dude right here. Unless this person lives closer. No, that's a different street. I'm gonna leave it alone. Who is this? John. All right. Can I call her?
Hey, Peggy, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Did you find what we need?
I think I know who to call.
I know who our best bet is to help Casey and Jason.
All right, good work. Who should I...
Hello? Is anybody there? Please pick up.
Casey, I'm here. What's wrong?
Jason started going pale.
Call John. He's going into shock.
God, it sounds like he's going into shock. Casey, just stay calm. It's going to be okay.
Did I knock something over?
Did I mess up? Jason, I'm sorry.
Put his legs up, keep him warm.
I've done everything right. I need you to listen to me, okay? For Jason.
What did the nurse say to do about shock?
Elevate his legs.
Casey, I need you to elevate Jason's legs. We need to get the blood flowing to his vital organs.
Got it.
Do we even need John?
Stay with me. I'm just gonna move you. This might hurt. Okay. I propped his legs up on some boxes.
I'm looking at my notes. We need to get Jason as warm and comfortable as possible. Do you have anything you could use nearby, Casey?
Yeah.
Maybe not a blanket or something, because it'll get bloody.
I'll wrap him in some blankets.
Of course, she wants to use a blanket.
Sorry. Jason's bleached through his bandages.
Get another one.
Should I get him new ones? Or, oh God.
Apply an additional
one,
yeah.
Don't remove the bandage. Apply another one on top of it. Do you still have something you can use?
I've used the rest of the laundry to keep him warm.
Y'all pay attention. This stuff might come in handy one day. He's gonna be fine, man.
Jason is going to be fine. Just make sure he knows he's gonna be okay, okay?
Okay. Please. I can't give him what he needs. Please help. I can't lose him.
All right, Forrest, we need to hurry. Jason doesn't sound like he's doing too well. You said you knew who to call earlier?
Mm-hmm.
Who was it?
We need to call John Hedges. He lives on Nancy Drive. He didn't really participate in the first aid training, but he's a former war medic. He's probably the most trained person we have.
Really? I never really spoke to him before. He's a war medic.
I guess I don't need to bring this upstairs.
And according to Reggie's notes, John keeps all of his old equipment at his house.
I didn't read that.
He's something of a hoarder.
All right.
But that's good.
542-0735.
How did he know that?
Calling now. Let's hope he picked.
Who the hell is this calling me?
Did he have his number on here?
John, it's Forrest Nash here at KFAM. We have an emergency and we need your help.
Forrest, if this is a work emergency, then it can wait until the goddamn morning. Just leave me a note like everybody else.
A man has been stabbed by the Whistling Man, or... never mind. He's lost a lot of blood, and he's passed out. We need you to help him.
The Whistling Man? What kind of joke is this?
John, we're not kidding. A man is gonna die if we
don't help
him
asleep
right
the whole
now.
Time.
Seriously, I haven't been called on for over 10 years. Where's the patient? What's his condition?
He's at 25 Nancy Drive.
He just went into shock.
He got his friend to stem the bleeding, but he's gone into shock. He's passed out right now.
You say he was stabbed? Do you know the extent of his injuries?
From what we were told, he has two major stab wounds. One to the stomach and one to the leg. The knife is still in his leg, and the stomach wound is open.
Understood. Let me grab a few supplies and I'll head right over. Damned if he dies on my watch.
Thank you, John.
What's he talking about?
Well, let him know you're on your way.
John, a trooper. Hello, said, I'm gonna save that nigga.
There? How are we doing? What about now? Is he still thrashing?
He's passed out. Please tell me you found someone to help.
He's on the way.
He's on the way. My colleague will be there soon.
You hear that, Jason? Someone is coming. You're gonna be just fine. Just hold on for me, okay? Just hold on. Come on.
Hello, Casey. This is John Hedges. I'm here about Jason.
Can I go upstairs?
Guessing that's Jason there. Casey, I'm gonna need your help. Forrest, Peggy, don't you two worry. We've got this from here.
Nice.
Okay. Forrest, we'll call you back later. I have to go now. Good luck, everyone. God, I hope he's gonna be all right.
And
go back upstairs.
The show moves on. We're sending our best wishes to Jason.
Nice. Go.
Well, after all that excitement, I think we could use some music.
Come back upstairs when you're ready.
I'm going right now. Wait, okay, yeah. I almost forgot. I thought it was going to teleport me up there like last time. But we saved another one, though. Damn, we got two people killed. So we're like, what are we now? 5-2? How many people are we gonna deal with?
It's getting pretty late.
Yeah, it's like 3.
Your last break for the night, so try to enjoy it. Give me a buzz when you want to go back on air.
We can write to it, baby.
Let's roll.
You got it. We've got another call coming through, too. Oh, we have another call coming in. But...
2?
Hang on.
What's up, Peggy? Peggy?
You're gonna want to take this call off the air.
Who is it?
Just do it!
Alright, folks, it's time for another track. Here's one to help you sit back and relax. We'll be right back after this.
Not bad, not bad.
I hope this is good news, Peggy. Who have we got?
Find out for yourself on line one.
Mr. Sheriff.
Hello?
Forrest, I'm glad I got back through to you.
Took your ass long enough.
Busy night, huh?
Surprise! It's Leslie, our 911 operator, leading the charge.
Not the sheriff, but you know.
Save us. It's so good to hear from you. Are you okay?
We're doing okay. Sarah and I are both happy to be headed back home.
We're happy to have you too. Wait, Sara?
Yeah, that name kind of threw me off a little bit.
Martinez.
Okay, okay.
Anyway, we got back into radio range a little while ago.
Why you ain't called?
But haven't been able to get through until now.
It's been nonstop since you left. Please tell us you're bringing help.
You bet.
I'm leading a whole goddamn squad towards Gallows Creek as we speak. Turns out somebody had cut the phone lines.
That's crazy.
They had no idea what was happening.
That's great news! That's crazy about the phone lines, though. Do you think the whistling man cut them?
I'm guessing so. I don't know how the whistling man did it. But that doesn't matter right now. Listen, we're coming in hot, but we need your help. I know Gallows Creek isn't a big town, but if we don't know where the whistling man is, we can't get him. Her. That's where you come in.
What you need, bro?
You can count on us. What do you need?
It might be a long shot, but here goes. The whistling man already called up a few times. I bet she calls again.
She's listening.
Out of town, so if she calls, stall her. Buy as much time as you can for us to get in.
It's not gonna work. She's listening to the station.
Figure out where she is. We'll be listening in. So once her location is known, we'll
head
straight there and end this nightmare.
She about to come to the station.
I'll do my best.
I know you.
She about to be at the station.
I can see the headlines now. Forrest Nash's interview of a lifetime. Anyway, I'll radio the other cars and tell them the plan is a go.
I need Ponzi to call me again.
Hopefully the next time I see you, it'll be with our killer behind bars.
I need Ponzi to call and lighten up the mood, bro.
We'll see you soon, Leslie. Oh, thank God.
Okay, that wasn't on the air. That's right.
We're nearly through this.
Best we don't waste any time then. Let's get back on air.
You got it. Okay, Forrest, shut the music off. Bringing you back live now.
Welcome back to The Scream with me, Forrest Nash.
You got another caller?
The line is lit up, but before I get to our next caller, I just want to say things are looking up.
Why are you giving hints, bro?
Let's bring in our next caller.
Man, fuck hope, bro.
This is Forrest.
You trying to give everybody hope, but you giving hints away.
This is John Hedges. I'm here with Casey. I wanted to give you an update on Jason.
John, is he gonna be okay?
He's a fighter. He'll be fine.
Nice.
He got stabilized and resting in a bed. We're preparing to move him to the hospital.
Thank you so much.
That boy John,
you
the goat.
You haven't been there, then. God, I don't even want to think about what would have happened.
Of course, Casey. We're just happy he's okay.
John, Casey, you two did all the work. Tell Jason to get well soon from us, whenever he's up for it.
Well, why don't you tell him yourself?
Is this Forrest?
The one and only. I hope you're feeling better.
It's good to hear you, Jason. How are you?
Oh, well, you know, I've got a hole in my stomach.
And your leg.
There's a knife in my leg, but John gave me something to take the edge off. So, I might feel even better than either of you.
You got a song request you want? I'm gonna switch
the
song.
Take it easy until you get to St. Gabriel's.
I will. But, before that, I needed to call you. I'm guessing the whistling man is still out there.
Whistling woman? Why do we keep saying that? What you think?
Yes, the whistling man's still out there. Why do you ask? You know something about the whistling man, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Can we talk about what happened earlier?
Go for it.
Casey said when you were attacked, your assailant said something like, "It's not so funny now." Do you know what they meant?
I do. I've heard that voice every day in my head for almost 20 years.
Every day? Does the killer live in Gallows Creek?
No, not exactly.
Hey, guys, I'm really sorry, but there's a call on the other line. I just need to make sure we don't have another situation brewing. You fill Jason in on what happened. I'll be right back.
Alright.
Forrest, have you ever heard of somebody called George Barrel?
The boy who drowned?
Sounds like everything's finally coming out now. It's been tough.
Yep, like I said, the killer's still trying to cover it up.
Back about something awful, Jason.
I'm part of the reason my best friend is dead, Forrest.
Some best.
And the few who knew about it said if I ever said anything, I'd find myself in jail for a long time. It was hell.
He's your best friend, bro. You gotta suck
it
up.
The town just moved on, like he'd never existed.
Who killed him?
Who killed George that night?
Just give us a name.
Some of the guys on the football team had an idea for a way we could haze the newcomers. We decided to plan a party in the woods and have the whistling man crash it. It was stupid. We each had a role. I was the stabbed friend. At the party that night, I left the group for a second, met our whistling man, pretended to get stabbed in front of everyone, started an almighty panic. Those screams. That was the last time I saw or heard George alive.
How did George die, Jason?
I don't know. I was playing dead. But when I heard her scream...
Who?
Her?
Yeah. George's girl.
Do you remember who she was?
Yeah. He called her Bean. I heard her again tonight, Forrest.
It's dawn.
Her name was...
What?
What
happened? Are we still on air?
No, we're not. Seems like the power is completely gone.
How do we get it back on?
I don't, we can use the emergency generator down in the basement. Reggie picked it up a while ago in case we ever needed to do an emergency broadcast.
An emergency broadcast?
You know, nuclear war, alien attack, broadcasting a serial killer's location to the cops.
Fair point.
It's in the storage area in the far back corner, up on the wall.
Okay. That's what I was looking at earlier.
It'll have a big red button. Just press that. Oh, see you when you're back.
Well, I'm going to turn this down a little bit. I know shit about to get spooky. Why don't they have flashlights? But the clock light still works. It must be a battery. This is the stairs, right? Yeah. Some of the lights are still working. But these are probably, what are they called? Floodlights? Is this the... No, okay. I keep forgetting. This is so... I hate this. I don't like this at all. Something's gonna happen.
Far back corner. Why is this station so big?
Yeah, really, bro. I'm expecting something.
That must be it. Boom! We've got power.
Nothing. Okay.
The whistling man. I need to warn Peggy.
Warn Peggy? Fuck Peggy. Just don't stop. Here it comes. I'm gonna see it at the door, I bet. It's gonna be at the front door.
Hell?
Maybe not. I'm scared. I'm very scared. We made it. That was light. What the fuck, Peggy?
Oh no.
Why did this bitch come out? She gotta be through here, right?
I'm not getting in there tonight.
Where the fuck is Peggy? I'm not looking for her. Oh, me, I'm not.
Why is it locked?
Do I need to go in here? Did she leave a note or something?
Hey, where'd you go?
Oh shit.
No way. This can't be happening.
What's up? What do you want me to... He wants to go live? How do I make him live? Can I lock this door?
A call.
How do I work this? How the fuck do I work this? I don't know.
Did Dawn press the Peggy button? Did she want me to hit it on my end?
Oh, what? Okay, this light. Where's Peggy?
Have some patience for us.
So this is Dawn. The end of the night. Why is she so tall?
It's the end of the show, but it's not over just yet. Got a little time still. So let's make the most of it.
All right, what's up?
All right, let's.
I'm happy to hear that. Huh? I thought we'd end tonight's Whistling Man special with a special guest. The one who started it all.
Who is this?
So let me take that out of your mouth and...
You crazy bitch!
What is going on?
Let me go!
Welcome to the air, Mr. T.
So it is two people. I knew it.
Wait.
It's all gonna come out tonight.
So who the fuck is this?
Your daddy and his money saved you 20 years ago. But even if he crawled out of his coffin with all the money in the world...
Wait.
I want one of these.
Where the hell is Teddy? How are you talking to him if you're here with me?
Because I'm not there with you, Forrest. I'm here with Teddy. And if he says where that is, well, he knows he'll get it.
Then who is this?
Wait, then...
I said it earlier. I said it's two people.
Forrest Nash, let me introduce you and all of Gallant's Creek to my boy, Henry Barrow.
George's brother? Wait, wasn't George a Barrow?
You mean you... Like that he...
Yes, Forrest. He and I had a son.
Wait, George?
So there were two whistling men tonight. Of course. That explains how you were always able to get around town so quickly.
Yeah.
And that's how you escaped the secret archives in the newspaper.
Somebody let him out.
Don't think I forgot about that, Forrest. Locking my sweet boy away like an animal.
Hang on. Did you say... Barrow?
Wait.
Are you...
Let me just get this mask off. Damn uncomfortable thing.
Hold up.
Crazy wearing this.
This girl's... Hold up. I'm sorry. This girl just started playing some shit and that shit's too loud. She got to turn that down. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back.
There we go.
Marie? Marie Campbell?
Okay, so Donna was a fake name.
Old girl. Oh. Well, it sure has been years since I last saw. Oh, God.
So because of a prank 20 years ago, she wanted to kill everybody?
Where are you going with all
this? This is weird.
Everyone's gonna know now what Teddy did. He killed George that night. This night. 20 years ago.
So this is George's son!
You're gonna talk when I talk to you. And not a moment before. Meanwhile, Forrest, I'm gonna give you the chance to talk.
Can I save him?
You're gonna help me reveal what really happened. Years ago.
We might as well, because we already know.
Okay, Marie.
Justice for George, right?
Then let's talk about the night George was murdered.
Murdered? Listen, I...
Well, we still don't know how he died. She is whooping his ass.
I said you speak when you're
speaking. She whooping his ass.
Now, I know you've done some good work tonight in piecing together what happened to George 20 years ago. And that's why I want you to interview us.
Alright. I can do that.
Alright. I can do that.
Thank you.
I'm down.
I want you to help me and Teddy tell the story.
But where is Peggy?
Do a good job. And hell, you might be the only one to leave here alive.
Say less. Fuck these other niggas. Say less.
I need to drag this out. If I can buy Leslie time to get back to Gallows Creek, and if I can find out where Marie is, then this can end. Teddy, we'll start with you.
I'm looking at my mic levels.
Talk me through what happened that night.
It's just stuff going. Let me close the door.
How would I know? It was 20 years ago.
Okay. Hit him, Marie.
Hit him again, Marie.
Bro, we know what happened, bro. That's funny.
Our first team party was coming up, and when I saw the date it was scheduled for, I had an idea for a way we could prank the new
guys.
The Whistling Night, right?
I understand that kids in Gallows Creek know tonight as Whistling Night. I'm guessing that's what you mean?
Well, we didn't have a name for it then. It was just the night that Mooney went missing. But Whistling Night is what they'd call it later.
Wait. You mean this was the first Whistling
Night? She's just stomping around.
Keep talking, Teddy.
We went up near Whistling Point. God, who was there? Me, Jason, and George, of course. But George didn't come alone.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to...
brought Marie. About midway through the night, we put the prank into action.
We looked up at the trees and saw Jason there. Bloody, like he'd just been stabbed. And the Whistling Man, screaming. George and I and Ricky, we got left behind.
Wait, Ricky was there?
Roller Ricky.
Roller Ricky?
He was. And he was in on the whole thing.
How do you know?
How did you know that Ricky was in on it?
Teddy and Ricky were as close as anybody. I can't believe for a second that Ricky didn't know the plan.
I never told... Damn it!
Ricky
told Stop talking, man.
He just told us. He and George would both be alive still.
Well, if Ricky weren't dead, we could have heard his side of the story.
It was just a stupid prank.
Hit him.
Hit him again, Marie.
Stop talking, Teddy.
God damn it!
You and George think Jason had been murdered. He thought his best friend was dead.
And so tonight you stabbed him for real?
It's the role he wanted to play.
Jason's still alive, Marie. He was with a friend. We talked her through how to stop the bleeding.
Probably shouldn't have told her all that.
Got him professional help just in time.
What's the point of bro flipping his couch, though?
Well, shame he didn't have the good sense to die earlier. He's gonna regret that. Enough about him. Me and George took off running, but somehow we got separated in the woods. I ended up near the bottom of Whistling Point. George wasn't with me, I panicked. And then, I don't know how he snuck up on me, but the Whistling Man grabs me, I scream, and he starts laughing, telling me it's just a joke.
I can stall for time here.
How did you feel?
How did you feel in that moment?
I felt like nothing was real. I felt small.
Who was under the mask, Marie? Who was the Whistling Man?
It was Chuck. Chuck Brody. Laughing away. But then he stops. And he's looking up. At the top of the
Did Chuck die?
Point.
What was he looking at?
Another Whistling Man, probably?
Said it. What happened next?
Nothing. I mean, it was just
Teddy.
George fell off Whistling Point.
Why'd he fall, Teddy?
You pushed him. You were up there.
Hit that nigga.
You were dressed as the Whistling Man too, and...
I didn't push him, goddammit! I just chased him up there, and he kept backing up.
Should have said it was a joke when you seen him at the edge.
Over. I reached out. That's what you saw.
Liar!
It's not my fault. He didn't know it was a joke.
They took it too far.
If he had any brains, he would
now you wanna talk? Hit that nigga. Hit him again.
Bitch. No one's going to believe this. After all you did.
They did do a lot.
If she's lying, why the cover up?
My future was at stake, Ash. You know,
if it was an accident,
like,
you know what I mean?
Like us,
well, nah, I think you probably get in trouble for this regardless.
I'm going to be the mayor of this town, Forrest.
Not if you die tonight.
And then, governor. And then, who knows?
I wouldn't be too upset with him dying tonight.
That night was tragic. It should never have happened. But it was a mistake.
Apologize.
It was just a stupid joke. Gone wrong.
He hasn't said sorry this whole call.
So my father sent Clive out to clean it up. Why should a blip ruin my future?
Because you ruined somebody else's. He wasn't a blip.
He wasn't a blip, Marie.
His father covered it up from there.
I wouldn't be too upset about Uber dying. Me personally.
Sandra found him the next morning while out jazz running.
She found him in the river, but she lied about that to protect Teddy.
She said something about her rent going up. Unless she... Teddy.
She had a reason.
Did your father own Sandra Sharp's dance studio?
Don't lie. It's
Gallows Creek. Not Shark Creek.
It's a, yeah, hit him again.
Hit him again, Marie.
Damn it. Yes.
Just answer the question, bro.
Okay. We own most of the town.
That's it, then. Your father was going to run her out of business unless she lied and said she found him in the reservoir instead of the river.
What my father did in his business...
Is his father dead?
...is nothing to do with me.
It was all your fault, though.
That's why you killed Sheriff Matthews, too, isn't it, Maria? Not just to get him out of the way, but...
Everyone was in on it, Forrest. Even the coroner wrote a fake report.
Yeah?
Said George was drinking. That he just got himself into trouble. And...
I saw. I'm sorry. For all it's worth... Virginia didn't have much of a choice. She had a sick sister whose treatments she couldn't afford. She played along with the gallows to save her sister's life.
I understand her.
And her own.
Yeah.
Even still, she should have told the truth. I did my part. I tried.
You can't be mad at Virginia.
I even went to the newspaper, but no. That coward killed the story. We'll take care of Maurice Russell later.
I didn't save him.
You've been through hell, Marie. I'm sorry.
You've got no idea.
I mean, what?
Should have started. You shouldn't have pushed my George off a cliff. You should have been punished.
This is really a bizarre reason to go through, you know, killing everybody.
Here, where George and I first met.
But she had to be crazy, of course.
Wait a sec.
They're at the school.
You're at Gallows Creek High, in the gymnasium.
That's right, Forrest.
What's up?
Not that it matters. Yes, we're here. Anyway, I think that about wraps up the interview with Teddy. So.
Don't kill me.
Marie? Where?
What the fuck is Peggy doing?
Peggy!
Teddy?
What the fuck is Peggy?
You gotta help me.
Quiet. You'll talk more later.
Where the fuck is Peggy?
To talk to someone who mattered more than you ever did. Peggy. It's been so long since I've seen
you. Don't kill Peggy.
I worried you wouldn't come.
Marie! Oh my god.
Are they friends?
And here I was, thinking you'd forgot me.
I'd never forget my own sister.
This is your nephew? What the fuck?
Peggy, what's happening?
Your nephew here trying to kill me, Peggy.
Explain, Peggy.
Earlier, while you were speaking to Jason, I got a call. Do you remember?
Wow.
It was from Dawn. She said that my sister Marie was there that night George died, and that I should come to the gym for a reunion.
And when you walked in, you found out
that my sister is the
Peggy should have said something about that, though.
Good to see you too, Peggy.
Why didn't you tell me?
Yeah, really?
She said that it was my last chance to see my sister.
Now she about to kill your dumbass.
I knew if I told you, you'd try to stop me or come with me when we need you on the radio. And I just...
I'm sorry. I don't know.
This has to be a lot for you.
I just...
So we got the location out. So I think we're good. Now we just gotta stay alive and hope this nigga don't try to kill us. I should have kept that screwdriver with me. It's sitting right there on the desk. Damn. What are you talking about?
Next best thing.
It sounds like she wants to kill Peggy.
Someone has to pay for what they did.
Murray, please.
Mom and Dad are gone, Peggy. Besides, you forgot me.
No, she didn't.
Just like the rest. You forgot.
Is there any way I can prove Peggy didn't forget Marie?
I could just say it. Oh, what is this? Happy birthday. Can I read this shit? Her chicken scratch ass handwriting. It's gotta be something in here, right? I can't. No, I can't get out.
It hurt to be forgotten.
He said.
I never forgot you. Well, no one's gonna forget now.
What was I supposed to do? Bruh. Damn. R.I.P. Peggy, bro. Should have said something, stupid. Damn, so what am I now? Like 5'3"?
Henry, kill him.
Wow. I guess I'm dead, huh? I ain't going out like without a fight, motherfucker. What's up? I ain't going out like no home. Okay. Ah! Oh shit.
You have to do it. There's still time to make the right decision.
Bitch. Look, your mama, look. No! Let me grab some.
Henry, get out of there!
We have one wounded and we're in pursuit of the suspect.
Bitch ass nigga, yeah. I threw that pen at his little hoe ass.
Freeze.
Can I leave? Far. Close the door.
Leslie, how's Peggy?
Oh my god.
Peggy, where's Marie?
Gone. Bolted right as we got here. The police are right on her.
Y'all better catch that bitch.
It's over, Forrest.
Wow. Are these all the people that died because of me? Why am I back down? Where am I? Where the fuck are we? I guess these are like the credits. This game was cool though. This game was really cool. I got a lot of people killed, bro. Damn. Can I leave? Open the door to skip the epilogue and credits. Hell nah. I got a lot of people killed, bro. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Damn, how many? 14 people died, bro. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Damn, we went 8 and 14. Damn. This shit was cool, though. This game, wow. Where am I though? This game was cool. If you like this game, bro, drop more games like this in the comments. I'll play more shit like this. Well, I don't really have much more to say. Opening door to skip the epilogue and credits. I did want to see, like, what happens next. But I'm not trying to wait for this credits to run. And I better not get copyrighted because of this shit. Where? Well, I guess I'll skip past if anything else happens, you know what I'm saying, I'll show it in the video. But if not, I guess I'll just skip to where the police cut in on the radio and say something. So this last part of the video gonna be quick. They sound like they got him. Going out like his daddy, huh?
Officer Luca, do you have a visual?
Negative. No sign of the suspect anywhere.
They got away. Alright, I'm done. I'm not finna keep waiting for the police radio to say something. Wait, it looks like it might be the end. Okay, it is. What? Hey! Killer Frequency, y'all. This game was dope. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you like the channel. You wanna be an ace? Subscribe, anyone can excel. Once again, sorry this video came out a little late. I guess it really doesn't matter as long as it comes out. I need one more short game that I can probably finish in like a couple hours, because I need to make one more video. And then, I'm gonna be playing Starfield a little bit. But I hope you enjoy it. We out.